So I couldn't get on the internet, right? And now I'm panicked. 3 hours disconnected. Anything could have happened. And in the end, I had to relent. I had to get an engineer to come out and have a look at my computer. And where I live, there's a brilliant company called Geeks on Wheels that come out and they come out and fix your computer, right? 70 quid an hour. That's their starting, right? And it was quite expensive, isn't it? But for that, you are getting a very official-looking fleece. I mean, it's proper. It's got the little pen pocket on the sleeve. That's a pro, isn't it? It's a pro. And he had the look of a gentleman who hadn't been on a date with a member of the opposite sex for quite some time. So I knew he had the sort of focus, concentration that I needed in this delicate situation, right? And I took him into my study and I showed him my computer. And I've got one of those under the desk ones, like a tower computer, right? And I pulled it out. I said to him, look, mate, can't get on the internet. I've got work to do, panicking, kittens, etc. I said, look at my computer, right? Look at it. I said, is it the computer's fault? Because it clearly wasn't mine. I said, isn't the computer's fault? And he pulled it out and then look at it and he went, I've got to be honest with you here, madam. They've always got that slight adenoidal problem, haven't they? It's like techie blokes, they've always got that slight, have you noticed that? Maybe I'm being prejudiced. Maybe I'm being totally prejudiced here. Maybe it wasn't an adenoidal problem. Maybe he just sucked up quite a lot of fluff from his own fleece over the previous week. Quite a big build-up, you know, like a bathroom extractor fan that needed a good hoover. Anyway, so he said, I've got to be honest with you here, madam. He went, this is what we call in the business, an entry-level computer. And then gave me a little smug sort of, all right, you fleecy fuckwit. It's a brilliant expression, though, isn't it? I love it. Entry level. When he said it, I went, oh, God, I love that expression. It's because you hear it more and more, don't you? About stuff that you can purchase and acquire. You do hear it, don't you? You can decide to go entry level, can't you? And I was sat there and I just thought, do you know what? You get people like that, don't you? Entry level. You do, don't you? It always gets a little bit tense in the show when I say this. I can feel people going, oh, no, sorry, no, no, no. All humans are equal. We're not. Listen. I'm not being cruel here. They are human. They're human. Just don't expect too much from them. Do you know what I mean? I tell you, my friend, when you start looking for them, fucking everywhere. Trust me. I can still feel resistance, it's all right. I'll get you on side, it's all right. I'll break you down slowly, it's all right. I'll give you a couple of examples of what I would consider an entry-level human and see if you agree. Should we go from there? Yeah. Okay, yeah? Back of the room? Yeah. Yeah? Okay, lovely. That was nice height. Well harmonised back of the room. That was yeah. You're welcome.
Beautiful.
Entry level. Let's start really basic. An entry level human for me is somebody who sits in a very public area, playing music very loudly on their phone, but doesn't bother to utilise headphones, therefore making sure everybody around them has to endure their noise pollution. That is surely an entry level human, isn't it? Yeah. You've all experienced that, haven't you? Yeah. You've all had it. But you've fucking never said anything, have you? You've just meerkatted up going, somebody should say something about that. Are we getting the idea in entry level? Entry level humour for me is people, and there was lots of them, came down to my beautiful city of Brighton Hove during the heatwave this summer, right? Had a picnic on the beach, had a lovely picnic on the beach, enjoyed their picnic on the beach, and then finished their picnic on the beach and left the beach, leaving all of their picnic detritus on the beach. There you go. Livid from all the shots. There you go. Why would you do that? Why would you destroy the one thing you've come to enjoy? It makes no sense to me. I mean, surely that is an entry-level human, isn't it? That's like spending 2.5 hours doing your own hair and makeup and then spending the next 2.5 hours just repeatedly punching yourself in the face, isn't it? Makes no sense whatsoever. Are you getting the idea? Yeah. Yes, okay, lovely. Entry-level human. The gentleman 2 years ago on a train who decided he was going to take the piss out of my wife and I behind our backs by doing licky-licky lesbo impressions to his colleague whilst we looked out of the window. Well done. What he hadn't factored in was the reflective quality of glass. So while to all intents and purposes it looked like I was enjoying the view of the fields in the distance, what I was actually watching was a reflection of a grown man in a business suit doing this behind my back. I caught his eye in the window in the reflection, span round and caught him mid... That is not an easy pose of which to style your way out of. An entry-level humour. We're getting the idea, yeah?